Bending is a common action that we all witness every day. Bending is forcing something into an angle. Here I have a wooden dowel in my hand, and I'm going to force this into an angle and bend it slightly. As you can see, the dowel bends. And let's take a look at the free body diagram of this dowel when it is bending. If I apply a force large enough, the bending becomes excessive and the dowel breaks. This is a simple demonstration that shows the effect of bending. In engineering, bending is very common. Beams and shafts are widely used structural elements, and they are subjected to bending. As we have seen, bending can cause serious damage. It's very important engineers determine the stresses in these members caused by bending so they can avoid failure. This is the subject of our discussion today. We want to determine the stresses caused by bending. In many applications, you can visually see bending. However, it is not always intuitive and visual. To make sure you can see how bending occurs, I want to show you a simple example outside. Let us consider this weightlifting bar. This rod is 36 inches long and it has 17.5 pounds on each side. Let me lift this bar. Now let us draw the free body diagram of this rod. The forces due to the weights are shown at the end of the bar. The reaction at the hands must be equal and opposite to weights due to the symmetry. Now let us draw the free body diagram of the center portion of the bar. The force of the weight and the reaction form a couple on each side. As you can see, this bar is in bending. Bending creates normal stresses. These normal stresses are tensile and compressive. To demonstrate this, let me show you a pool noodle. Pool noodle is very flexible, and you can easily see which part is compressing and which part is expanding. Let me bend this pool noodle as I did before with the wooden dowel. See how the noodle bends. If you look closely, the top portion of the noodle is stretching, causing tensile stress. Look at the thick line I have drawn on the top surface and see how it is elongating. Take a look at the bottom portion in which the noodle is compressed, creating compressive stress. In summary, bending is a very common occurrence in engineering. Beams, shafts, and other structural elements are all often subjected to bending. It's important for engineers to determine the bending stresses. Let us now develop the equation for bending stress.